Today marks the 75th anniversary as the ANZAC Day was commemorated yet again for another year to signify the Australia-New Zealand expedition in the World Wars. In Rabaul, a small dawn service this morning hosted by the Rabaul Historical Society brought together residents of Rabaul and relatives of war veterans to pay respect to those who fought and died or perished during the wars. Representatives from the Australia and New Zealand Army also came to show their respect to their fallen comrades. Rabaul has a rich history of the Second World War. Rabaul was a former Australian territory that was acquired from Germany through the Geneva Convention at the end of the First World War. In January 1942, during the Second World War, Rabaul was invaded by the Japanese and converted to one of their fortresses in the South Pacific during the war. But what's more historical about Rabaul is that the Australian troops who were stationed here suffered more casualties compared to any other Australian units encountered during the World Wars. About 1,400 Australian soldiers were left in Rabaul to protect the territory, but they were outnumbered by the Japanese troops who arrived both on air and sea. They were forced to retreat inland towards the harsh vegetation of New Britain. About 400 of the troops escaped to the mainland New Guinea, whilst another 160 were massacred indiscriminately at Toll Plantation on the eastern coast of New Britain. While similar dawn services are held in various parts of the world to remember the days of war, in the old volcanic town of Rabaul, the war veterans always come back to pay their respect to their fallen comrades who died fighting, trying to save their territory. And it is with these small dawn services on every ANZAC morning that commemorate their wartime stories. Edwin Fidelis, National MTV News, Kokopo.